Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to EACTA webinar on the perioperative management for COVID-19 patients in such unprecedented time. And by the end of this webinar, you should understand the principles of airway management for COVID-19 patients, perioperative care for patients with suspected or diagnosed COVID-19 infection who undergo cardiac and thoracic surgery, and the perioperative management and the postoperative management and the critically ill management for such patients with COVID-19 infection. I am Mohamed, professor of cardiothoracic anesthesia at Mansoura University, Egypt, and working at Imam Abdurrahman bin Faisal University in Saudi Arabia. I am EACTA Educational Chair. And without further ado, I want to present our first speaker today, Dr. Massimiliano Sorbello from Catania, Italy. He is from Policlinico Vittorio Emanuele San Marco, and he is the President-elect of European Airway Management Society. He has a lot of publications, and he's a famous international speakers in different international events. And he will talk about lessons learned from airway management of COVID-19 patients, Italian experiences. Just a little housekeeping. You can type your questions in the chat box in question and answer, and we'll address all questions at the end of the webinar before closure. Thanks so much. You can start, Massimiliano.
Good evening or good morning. It depends where you are in the world. I am Massimiliano Sorbello. I'm an anesthesiologist. I come from Italy, and I'm very happy to be here with EACTA for this webinar, just to share our experience and knowledge for lessons learned for airway management with COVID-19 patients, what we learned here in Italy and what we try to share with everybody in the world. I'm an anesthesiologist. I've been working with many companies in the field of airway management, so this is my disclaimer and my conflict of interest. And we will go very fast to the topic of our lecture. So as I told you in advance, I live in Italy, I work in Italy, and it's been really hard times for us. We were the second country in the world after China to be devastated by the COVID-19 infection. This is one of the pages of our Institute of Health you see updated today. On April 27, we had almost 26,000 deaths, almost 200,000 people with infections, and it's been really a plague which killed a lot of people and put our health system really on its knees. In this perspective, I want immediately to highlight data that almost 11% of infected people were healthcare workers, and that today we count more than 150 colleagues who died because of COVID-19 or during COVID-19, because they were involved in first line or dealing with the virus. So I want to honor them, remembering them also in this slide for my lecture. This is what we did with our national society. So a couple of days after the beginning of the lockdown, our scientific society, which is CRT, we start to work very hard to try to produce a series of documents for all anesthetists working in Italy. And this was produced by the research group for airway management and immediately shared with the world. So it went through ESA, it went to many different societies. It was spontaneously translated in German, in Spanish, in Portuguese, and it was some kind of help or support, and it ignited a really tight and dense network of collaborations, and this webinar is also one of them through which we are trying to share our knowledge and experience in this battle against the virus. So what we can outline in this lecture today is a brief talk about personal protective equipment, what is the decision to intubate, and then very briefly for pre-oxygenation, intubation, rescue of the airway, extubation, and importance of teamwork. Going to the first point, which is the personal protective equipment, we were used to see all this stuff only in movies, and it's amazing how these movies were so close to what we live today as reality or as a nightmare. So we used to see Dustin Hoffman in Outbreak wearing a kind of special suit. And this is basically what we are doing now every day in our daily practice. If we think of the virus, it's really a complex issue because right now we don't have yet a specific therapy or vaccine. We don't know so much, or we are not great with sensitivity and specificity of diagnostic tests. We know that it can be transmitted also from asymptomatic patients with R0 about 3, so reproduction number is quite high. And mostly we don't have clear ideas about the modality of transmissions of the virus. So we know for sure that it goes through droplets, so these larger drops contain the virus. We know for sure that it goes with direct contact through surfaces. It can go also with fomites. Then there's some evidence for bloodborne infection to be transmitted, but this is really low. The same for mother to child, the same for orofecal transmission. But the biggest doubt we have today is if this virus might have some airborne diffusion. So airborne means smaller nuclei